Do you want to learn some quick and easy ways you can speed up Final Cut Pro 10 today? If you want to learn that, stay tuned. Hey there, I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys. Now, if you're into Final Cut Pro 10 or filmmaking, consider subscribing to this channel because that's what we're all about. Now, if you're trying to edit 4K footage on a MacBook Pro or an older Mac, you know it can really slow down sometimes. So in this video, I'm gonna show you some little tweaks you can make to Final Cut Pro 10 to make it run much faster than ever before. You know, we've all been there when we've tried to import 4K footage into Final Cut Pro 10, you get it on the timeline, you add a title or something, and it just slows down super slow. So let's jump into the tips and I'll show you how you can speed it up today. Tip one. Now the first tip is to turn on better performance. Go over to the drop-down box here and tick this option. Now this just might be enough to make it run fast enough for you, and it will certainly help. Now you will notice it will decrease the quality of the footage, but it will certainly boost performance. Number two, after this, pull up your media import window. Under this transcoding section, you can select between two options. Now to help Final Cut run faster, tick this box here to create optimized media. And this will basically create ProRes files from your original video footage, and they basically run much faster in Final Cut Pro 10. Then if you're working with 4K or really high-end footage like Red cameras or the new Blackmagic camera, tick this box here and underneath where it says create proxy media. When you close this down, go to your drop-down box here, and then you can switch from optimized original to proxy. This will make your entire editing process smoother and it will make it easier to edit. But just remember, when you're ready to export, switch back to the original. Tip three, another useful tip to speed up Final Cut Pro 10 is to show your clips in list mode. Now, when you scroll to this section where your clips are, they do have to render a little bit first before showing you previews. So instead, go over to this icon here and make it into list view instead. This actually really helps speed up Final Cut, and it's only going to render the little film strip here at the top. Tip four. This one is to change the clip appearance. Go down to the bottom right of your screen and click on this icon here. The one at the far right will usually be the best option for Final Cut Pro. Tip five is to close unused windows. So to close down the inactive windows that you're not using at the time, pressing Command 4 will close down your inspector, and then hitting Command 5 will close down your effects panels. You know, when all your panels are open, this will actually use a little more CPU. So canceling this out whenever you can be a really efficient way of speeding up your software. And you know, every little helps. Now finally, tip six is to make sure that you use an external hard drive. You know, it can seem like an easy option to edit from a folder on your desktop, but this will really slow your computer down and Final Cut Pro down when you're video editing. And this really applies to all video editing software. You have to remember that if you're writing and encoding media to your internally built hard drive of your Mac or your PC, you're reading and writing to the same disk that you're using for Final Cut and the application to run. So you really want to be writing that media to an external hard drive, and this will seriously speed up your editing workflow. So there we go. I hope those tips have really helped you. Now, if you know any tips that I haven't mentioned here in this video, please leave a comment below as I'd love to hear from you, and I can include that in a future video to help other people. So thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up, hit that like, smash that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video.